Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. Thanks so much for taking the time out of your day to watch my video. I really appreciate it and I'm so happy to have you a part. So you guys, I officially made a website and a blog. Wow, this has been on my heart for the longest time. And I've been wanting to make a blog for a really long time and I finally did it, yay! If you're clicking on this video, then I'm sure you're curious, why did I say that so weird? Curious how you can do it for yourself. So I'm gonna share with you guys my experience, how I did it, and some tips that would be really helpful and beneficial for you. This is definitely a video for you to serve you if you are looking to make your own website or make your own blog, getting into social media and like the whole shebang. So I hope you guys like this video, and if you do, give it a thumbs up. That was a lot to say, I'm out of breath. Alright, so without further ado, let's get right into this video. I'm so excited to share with you guys everything that I have to offer. So like I said, making a blog has been on my heart for a really long time. I felt really like called to do it, but I didn't know like where to start or what to do. And it really wasn't until I watched Megan Lee's video on how she created a website that I got the ideas to kind of make my own and actually like take the steps on how to do it. So I made my website through Wix.com, which is the website that I believe Megan was working with on that video. So from that video, I gathered information and I got the link. I will leave the link down below if anyone's interested as well. But basically, Wix.com has so many templates and guides on how to create your own website. You can do anything from a blog website to a company website to a huge CAO to a like hobby website. You can literally do anything under the sun. You can even have an online store. They provide you with templates and then you can make it your own. You can change all the colors, the fonts, you can move things, you can add things, add all your videos, add all your pictures. You can like completely customize it. It's very user friendly. So that's exactly what I did. And honestly, I put so much work into it, but I finally got it to be like my style and my theme. I have 3 blog posts currently, which is amazing. So if you want to check out my blog post, then it's down below. I have a blog that is about me. That's like a little introduction. I have a blog on my mascara routine and a blog on just like self-love and forgiving yourself and being like the best version of yourself. Just kind of like a little like pick-me-up. So check those out if you are interested in them. I would truly appreciate it. I'd be so honored if you guys checked out my blog. I'll leave the link down below. But yeah, so it was really easy to put together, but it was time consuming. It took me to like complete everything from start to finish, like 60 plus hours. Sorry, girl, I put some work into it, but I like divided it up into time blocks and I didn't work on it like every day. I didn't work on it 60 hours straight by any means. I took different days and worked on different categories of my blog. One day I said that I'm gonna work on this section and this section. And then a few days later I would come back to working on it and I would complete this section and this section. So I definitely worked in time blocks, which is something that I definitely recommend for you if you're starting a blog. Take your time. Don't rush it, like just be patient and work in time blocks. Stay focused on certain categories when you are working within those time blocks. That is what helped me significantly, and it helped me like focus and pinpoint what I was working on in that moment. Even though I had like 10,000 other things that I wanted to work on and I was thinking about, that really helped me kind of like focus down, you know, like focus on what I was working on in that moment. Also, a very helpful thing that helped me tremendously and that'll help you too is getting inspiration from your favorite websites and your favorite bloggers. So going onto their page, picking up like what you like, some little things here and there, and then making it your own. So not copying anything by any means, but like picking up on ideas that you like and you want to implement, but then switching it up and making it your own. That was really helpful on things that I was asking myself, like how do I want to set this up, or what do I need to include in this, or how do I want to make this look? It was really helpful looking at my favorite websites and my favorite bloggers' websites and just getting inspiration from them. Another thing that really helped me was jotting my ideas down. So I'm the type of person where I'll be in bed at 2 in the morning and all of a sudden all my ideas will hit me. So I made a little note on my phone, jotted down all my random ideas that I got throughout the day, throughout the night. I also have like an actual planner and a few notebooks that I keep by my desk, and that's really helpful. I made a ton of list ideas, like I just jotted my thoughts down, jotted my ideas down that I wanted for my blog, and then when it came time to working on the blog, I had my notes and I had my like notepad right in front of me because I could grab from it and I remembered it, because that's a big thing. Like you have so many things on your mind and then you forget certain things, like, oh, I wanted to add that, or I wanted that to like say that. If you write notes and if you like actually physically write things down, it helps you to remember that, and you can like go off of that for your blog. You don't necessarily even have to have a blog on Wix. You can just create a random website, not a random website, but like you can just like create any kind of website that you want to. you don't have to have a blog, but it is awesome that they give you the option to have a blog. So keep that in mind. They literally have everything set up for you from A to B. Your website and your blog can look so professional. Like, they have it down. So definitely take advantage of Wix. The only thing is that you have to pay to have your domain, to have it on Google. You can still, of course, publish your website and it'll be live to anyone that has the link. But in order to have it be like searchable on Google, you actually have to like pay a larger chunk of money. So that's like the downfall of Wix. But other than that, like, it's completely worth it. And that's the only thing that I really ran into that I'm like, what the heck? But regardless, your website is still up and running. People just will have to like use that link to get it if you don't pay for that domain. So I've given a few tips already, but my biggest tip probably has to be to use your website or your blog. If you're starting a blog, treat it like it's your diary. Like, literally pour your thoughts into it. Like, pour your thoughts into your blog. Pour your personal stories into your blog. People want things that are relatable, stories that are relatable, things in life that are relatable. So just like, jot your thoughts down, jot your stories down, like, be you, be unique. Don't like be a robot. Kind of like type as you would speak. Make it interesting, make it fun, just be you. That is the best way that I can explain it. Just be yourself. Like, type to your blog as if you're typing to your friends or your family. Just like, make it so relatable and open, transparent and honest. That's exactly how I want my blog to feel, and I hope that I have accomplished that. If you guys want to check out my blog, I will leave the link down below. I would be so happy and honored and just grateful and filled with so much joy to anyone that checks out my website and my blog. If you do, please leave me a comment and leave me some feedback. I would absolutely love to hear what you think about it. I'm always trying to improve and work on things, so anything that you have to say, I'm more than welcome to like take in and work on it, so please let me know. Also, if you are new here, please consider subscribing if you haven't already. We are at a goal to reach 100,000 subscribers, and once we get there, I will be holding that giveaway, like I said, so make sure you are telling everyone that you know to surprise and to surprise to subscribe and share my videos. I love you guys so much, and I will see you tomorrow or the next day in a brand new video. I upload about 4 to 6 days a week. Love ya. Bye.